the hell is Josh? I told him we were going to be filming. Josh! Josh!
Hey!
Oh my God!
Boom! So we got some great new books coming out this month. We got Abattoir, issue number 4. This was created by Darren Lynn Bousman, the director of the Saw franchise.
You might have heard of it.
It was a good one. And it's also written by Rob Levin and Troy Peteri. Amazing writers. The artwork in here is absolutely incredible.
A little gruesome.
Definitely gruesome.
But it's awesome.
And if you like scary, scary stuff, you are definitely going to like issue number 4.
Yeah.
Make sure you read up on it, though, because otherwise this isn't going to make sense. But it is an amazing book. Tell them a little bit about it.
Kind of where we're at is we've been following Richard Ashwalt, a realtor who has the unenviable job of selling a house where there was just a horrible murder by a clown, which, don't even get started. Anyway, so before they can even clean up the house, this creepy old guy, Jebediah Crone, shows up and he wants to buy it. And now Richard Ashwalt senses something's kind of off, doesn't want to sell it to him, and then weird things start happening in his life. It goes from bad to worse, and all of a sudden he's in the middle of a murder investigation as their prime suspect. So that's kind of where we leave off until number 4, which comes out
April 20th. Now, we can't tell you too much about number 4 because a lot is revealed about, is Richard crazy or is he not crazy? And you are definitely going to have to pick it up to find out. Check out this preview.
After refusing to sell a house with a violent history to an eerie old man, Richard Ashwalt's life is coming apart at the seams under mysterious circumstances. Now separated from his family and falsely accused of murder, Richard is at his wit's end. Trying to make sense of what's happening around him, Richard seeks out Jebediah Crone, the man who began the course of events that have left Richard's life in shambles and driven him to the brink of insanity. As Richard investigates Crone and the mysteries that surround him, the pieces of a horrifying puzzle begin to fall into place. But the solution could destroy him.
Also coming out this month, we have Ryder on the Storm, the 3rd issue by David Hines. He is sick and twisted and awesome. It comes out April 20th. Why don't you tell us a little bit about the story?
All right, now this is the 3rd one, so if you've been following books 1 and 2, you know that we're following Detective Ryder, who's been called by the sexy Katrina, whose boyfriend apparently committed suicide.
Brutally committed suicide.
Something's a little fishy. As Detective Ryder investigates, he finds out that the Dantons, the most powerful family in the city, are actually a race of demons. He also finds out that he himself is a demon, and that the Dantons are breeding even more demons underneath the city.
So you'll have to tune in to the 3rd issue to find out if he's going to follow the demon race, which is his race, or if he's going to save the human race. So make sure you check it out, and
yeah,
check out this
awesome
preview right here.
Ryder, Katrina, and Monk are only a few steps away from eliminating the demon threat. But standing between Ryder and the Drone Queen is his mother, the demon Rebecca Danton. Will Ryder choose his family or the human race before the Drone Queen unleashes her curse upon the world? The stunning conclusion to David Hine's newest horror mystery ends here.
Thanks for tuning in, and check back next week because we'll have some big announcements, as well as a review of ERP number 3. And I lost Josh. Let's go see if we can find him.